Here we are. N key, alpha draconian. Right? Was it not N key? What is this? N key is Sumerian Anunnaki god who created Homo sapiens by cross-fertilizing his DNA with Homo erectus. I mean, Lucifer. N key, Lucifer, the alpha draconian sympathizer, whom N key, Lucifer has responded to. You know, the reptilian, alpha draconian, the draconis, alpha draconi. Yeah, guys, what do you think's going on here? You got deceived by Lucifer. The governments got deceived by Lucifer. Lucifer deceived the whole world and made United Nations, you know, evil alpha draconian fallen angels like Satan, Sitin, Sanat, Enki, Santa Claus, Lucifer, Samael, god of this world. You know, 2 Corinthians 4:4 deceived the whole world, blinded the minds of you all, so that he can have his United Nations kill all you off in under 7 years of your mandate, the end of 2030, and then burn all of you in hell with his false Christ son. They put they created the Trinity and put the real God underneath them as the third person and countered your intelligence, inverting and blinding you from the truth. It's the truth, because Brahman's the real God, and Brahman created Brahma, and Brahma created the four Kumaras, and they're the four Kumaras. Sanat Kumara? Galactic Federation, yeah, Kumara, Enki. Enki Kumara, Ptah. Sun Nimrod, Horus, with Isis, Semiramis. They connect, right? They live, right? Anunnaki live, right? That's the Anunnaki. Enki, son of Anu. The Anunnaki. They live, right? Well, then who got deceived? The government got deceived. The whole world got deceived, right? They're ready to kill us all off, guys. They're killing us off slowly right now. They're murdering us with sugar, with chemicals, with food and water and chemtrails and vaccines and viruses. They're killing us all off with their lies, with their deceptions, with their divisions, with their wars, with their conflicts, with their United Nations peacekeeping. They're inversions of the truth. They're flip-flopping everything. Bipolar, mind-control, checkerboard on us, you know, the yin and the yang. You know what they do to the women and the children, guys? They give them the yin-yang, right, program, and it's everything's one way or another. It's black and white, all right? Right? It's Lucifer and Lilith. Pick one. You know, it's Lucifer and Lilith. It's Nimrod and Semiramis. It's Horus and Isis. It's the sun and the moon. That's it, right? It's left and it's right. It's red and it's blue. Pick side. Which side are you now? You know, they get you to think one way or another. And then they beta sex get in program. They turn your little girls into monarch butterflies. Right? They make them monarch butterflies. They make them think they transformed into gods. Because that's what Lucifer does, to pimp out the women and to pimp out the men. Sexualize them, feminize them. This is what he does through the beta sex kitten programming. And you can see Fritz Springmeier telling you how they do this. Fritz Springmeier, the Illuminati formula to create an undetectable total mind control slave. And this is what they did. So if anybody is obsessed with the yin-yang like I was as a kid, being programmed from a distance, you know, strange days we're living in from a distance. You know, this is quite an inception. You know, the Matrix, you know, They Live, documentary film, Metropia. How many more movies? Dark Skies? The Adjustment Bureau? You know, take an eagle eye on crack. Because your eyes are the cameras. Your ears are the microphones. And the 5G connects all things, your brains, with the neural link up there in the sky, and the satellites already there. And, CIA's involved, and the FBI's involved. You know, Amber Alert, that was created by Ted Gunderson, who was with the FBI for 30 years. You know, and they were trying to make him the director. He was the assistant director. They wanted to throw him down. They wanted to throw him under the bus, use him like a president, like Donald Trump and Joseph Biden, all these other guys as fronts, like, you know, Elon Musk is a front, you know, saying that they were summoning the demon with AI and CERN, you know, get the Large Hadron Collider opening up portals and stuff, right? They're looking it up, guys. They're doing this stuff. It's all right there. You know, they're taking pictures of the demons in there, and the United Nations, you know, call it for, you know, their mandate to depopulate us. Illuminati formula, you know, they're the, you know, who controls Hollywood, who controls the music industry. They all, the celebrities, are telling you that the devil, Lucifer, Sanat Kumara, the god of this world, and his son, the Antichrist, Baal, Moloch, Marduk, Nimrod, Tammuz, Horus, they're the ones that control the music industry in Hollywood and the world. They're the ones that created the Jewish Illuminati, or the fake Jewish, you know, the synagogue of Satan, like it says in the Bible. They're the synagogue of Satan, right? Revelations 4:19 or 19:4 or something like that. Look it up, guys. Fritz Springmeier, the Illuminati formula used to create a total mind-controlled slave, an undetectable total mind-controlled slave. Take a look at here, how the Illuminati create, you know. That's the eye of Lucifer, by the way, morons. The dollar bill, yeah, that's Lucifer and Key, Sanat Kumara, right? The alpha draconian parasite that rules this world, right? You all work for him, right? He deceived you all. You're going to die. You're going to die real soon. Take a look. Take a look, guys. Here's the Georgia Guidestones. Maintain humanity under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. This is some bullshit, right? No, it is some bullshit. I'll tell you that. That's the number one that they got to do, right? A new language so they can control you, right? All this stuff. Worry about fitness and diversity, right? Yeah, diversity with aliens. They're not aliens. They're their races, the fallen angelic races they created. They're not soul beings like us. But they want to, you know, manipulate your minds, manipulate your thoughts, release your perspectives. You know, those who make it. You know, the 500 million humans. And there'll be plenty of non-humans around here. Don't worry about that, right? It'll be a diverse world. And worry about your body, your fitness, not your mind, your spirit getting out of here, right? You know, it's just the sign of the times, guys. Sign of the times. This is how they created sex slaves. You know, like Britney Spears and Ashley Tisdale and Taylor Swift and Miley Cyrus and Beyonce and, you know, all the others in the bathtub, you know, throwing up the 666 hand sign, and they got the split fracture. You know, you go on Netflix and you see the split fractured minds. You know, why do they fracture the mind with fear and trauma-based mind control program and satanic ritual abuse? Well, they do that so they can create alters. You know, these alter egos. See this? This guy's got a split, probably. And this is their way. You know, the hot dogs, guys, and the tacos representing the little boys' penises and the little girls' vaginas in the Pedogate Pizzagate scandal. Well, that's what they're doing on Netflix. That's what they're doing on Disney. That's what they're doing all these movie covers and all these album covers. You know, because they control Hollywood and the music industry. And they're letting them know that your kids and your, you know, all these people are the highest class sex slaves. And that they can access their brain activity, access their dreams with the sentient world sensory simulation, with the 5G and the Neuralink, and all whatever they had already, and rape them. Strange days we're living in, guys. Strange days. You want to see the trailer? Let's show you what they've been doing. And this is a very, very old movie. 1995. Have a listen, okay? In 2000. The world's ending now, guys. Because the United Nations is ending our world, ending our lives. All for Lucifer, aka Sanat Kamara, aka the Alpha Draconian Reptilian Shapeshifter deceiving us all, right?
If you were on the fence about ordering McDonald's, consider this a sign.
About McDonald's, you should know that M basically stands for Marduk, Moloch, Mars, the Antichrist, his son, Sananda Kamara, according to him. You know, just stop your time. You know, you're crying, it's the end of the times, right? The sign of the times. But, you know, we really need to get away from here. You know, we look good from, you know, we look good down here from up there, but we're not good, right? Because look at this. Look at what's going on here, guys. They're accessing people's brain activity, their stuff from a distance. You know, they're raping and trafficking women and children, and they're you know, men, and they're calling them terrorists and threats to national security, targeted individuals, you know, government traitors and sellout whistleblowers, you mean. You know, all the people that are good people, you know, take a look at what they do. TCTI.proboards.com will bring you to the coalition of target individuals, the number one place for TIs and chat rooms and more. And you can go to experience and observations here, and you can go to share what you hear here, and you can, you know, look for Lyra. look for Lyra here, but you don't need to look for just Lyra. You know, you can see all their other stuff that they're saying into their heads directly with these technologies. But Lyra, 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 Lyra. Nobody raped you. I raped you. You don't remember. You didn't like it. You will get no tingling. We're not going to tingle you. Why do you like Freddy? That's what I call it when they move my body. So in other words, the implied cause and presupposition, this neuro-linguistic programming hypnosis that they're using, why do you like when they move your body? You know, you're not going to get any tingling from being raped. We're not going to tingle you. They call raping you tingle you, right? A little de-escalation, desensitization to being raped. Nobody raped you. You know, a little hypnotic suggestion. Nobody did it. Nobody raped you. Remember that. You weren't raped. Lyra, 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 Lyra. You know, remember, there is no Lyra. They always call me Lyra, and that is not my name. See, that's not our name, guys. That's the beta sex kitten they're programming, the monarch butterfly. That's the butterfly they're putting in her, making her a perfect little sex slave. She's the monarch butterfly, transformed into a sexual goddess. She just doesn't know. She just has no idea. She only knows when she's her, Lyra, their personality. See, Lyra's her personality, they told her subconscious mind over and over again. Lyra, Lyra, look in the mirror, see a little clearer. Reminding her that she's Lyra more and more in her subconscious mind, or that the identity that they're programming slowly with this hypnosis that they're doing on her with the voice of God weapons, the synthetic telepathy, the remote neural monitoring from the NSA, the CIA, the FBI, and these demons that are doing this to them. You know, basically Lucifer himself could be beta 6 getting programming your daughters and your sons and you and your wives, you know, your moms and your dads and your grandmas and your, you know, there's really no people that they don't do this to. They're all targeted individuals, guys. You know, the crazy people? The crazy people that hear voice in their heads that are not schizophrenic? Yeah, this is what they're going through. Getting raped and trafficked, turning into sleeper agents and school shooters and, you know, just about everything. But don't target them, because if you kill them, you're next. Because they learned a lot from research and developing all this stuff on them, using them as guinea pigs, thousands of years since Egyptian times. And don't forget the concentration camps, when they brought those Nazi scientists that were putting, you know, doing the mind control and pumping the fluoride that they're pumping in your water and your toothpaste and your mouthwash into their water. You know, don't forget when they brought them over with Operation Paperclip to, you know, do experiments on people in the hospitals and the, you know, the children's hospitals, like the one I was in, Bradley Hospital, when they removed me from my house twice and did this mind control program in me, you know, before 6 years old. You know, when I had the voices in my head and the doctor said voices in my head tell me to do bad things, I, you know, they wrote it down for me, you know, because I told them that. You know, at 6 years old, you know, they were molesting me from a child and trafficking me and other kids in this children's hospital, putting thoughts and, you know, sexual images and desires in our heads so we'd act them out together and they can experience it, you know, like Strange Days, the movie, right? Strange Days We're Living In, guys, Inception, The Matrix, and they're right in there, right in our brains with these headsets and these technologies, experiencing as the sexual fucking deviant fucking pig scum that they are, these satanic pedophiles, these Luciferian antichrist pedophiles and rapists and human traffickers pimping out anybody in it for anything, you know, for their devil god. Exposed, you know, they could do all this stuff. And it's not really about the money, guys. It's about their sexual desires. You know, the fallen angels, they had sex with women and created giants, the Nephilim, right? And about all the other sexual deviants on this planet that they, you know, that they get to be that disgusting, right? These perverts that don't just traffic. You know, the Sound of Freedom told you what we already knew. Did you know this? How about that, guys? You know, and just in case you're still questioning if this is real or not, let me show you that it is. Let's find Dr. Robert Duncan.
How's the government to transmit thoughts and voices into the heads of Americans?
I've worked on projects for the CIA, Justice Department, Department of Defense.
That's Robert Duncan, a former government agent, still probably works for the government a little bit. Gives a lot of speeches, lectures, TEDx talks, I believe he did. He created a lot of technology for the government, like including the Voice of God weapons that they're using. They got an entire Iraqi army to drop their weapons, thinking it was the voice of Allah in their heads. And by the way, Iraq is Babylon, and they got Gilgamesh's body, who they, you know, they worship, basically, his body in a resurrection chamber, and they brought him over here. Hillary Clinton got it in her emails talking about it, just so coincidentally, right before the Iraqi war. You know? So the other guy is Jesse Ventura, former governor in the United States, and this is his national television show on True TV.
For a fact that these weapons that you worked on, they're being used domestically today?
Absolutely.
Are there citizens of this country that are being abused with this technology?
Worse than abuse, that's a light word. They're being tortured. They easily could be broadcasting across the country messages to people and causing them extreme pain.
We've run into a few people that claim they got voices in their head. When they talk to us, they seem totally normal. Are these people crazy, or is the government doing this to them?
The government's doing this to them. They're called Voice of God weapons.
So the targeted individuals aren't crazy after all. These are people within our government at a certain level making these decisions, and they're not necessarily our president or our elected officials.
That's exactly right.
Now, this guy looked a little turtly and scared of Jesse Ventura. I mean, look at how big the guy is, and he might want to wring his neck and rip his head off for, you know, helping to do this stuff, right? But Robert Duncan has since, you know, helped us out and given us a lot of information. He's been a good guy. So, you know, just keep in mind, guys, that all this is going on. And while you go to work and they, you know, do this.
So now they're having an after-school satanic club for kids? What? And then y'all wonder why I preach Jesus so radically? Watch this video to the end.
Federal judge has just ordered Pennsylvania School District to allow after-school Satan Club. After-school Satan Clubs are now gaining popularity all over the United States. Ohio, North Carolina, and now Pennsylvania. Temple of Satan is sponsoring all of this, and you can go on their website and check out their handbook that they're teaching little kids. They're now looking to move into high schools. They're going to have student-led after-school Satan Clubs.
Now, do you realize they're in the elementary schools doing this? This is real, guys. Tucker Carlson did a thing on this and interviewed the Church of Satan or the Temple of Satan himself. And they were openly saying, yeah, it's great. But the guy looked scared, just like Robert Duncan, because he knew what he was doing was wrong. These are the end times, guys. They're trying to depopulate us, right? This is one way to depopulate and rape and trap and get whatever they want from people, targeting them. Another way is fluoride, just like the concentration camps, pumping it into the water and the, you know, the toothpaste and the mouthwash. It's straight up rat poison, guys. You didn't know that? It cuts you off from God, too. It calcifies that third eye, that seat of the soul. According to Rene Descartes, the seat of your soul, your pineal gland. Yeah, it turns it into a cyst. It gunks it all up and makes it so it cuts you off from the spiritual realms, from God, and leaving your body. You know that? That's what it really does. It dumbs you down. It causes Alzheimer's, dementia, cancer, and all these other things. Did you guys know that? You could sue them for more than, you know, they'll ever pay you right now for just that. Never mind all the other damages they've caused you and all the other things that they're pure evil that they're doing right now. Did you know that, guys? But no, they want you to go and get their fake paper money and then get a Mark of the Beast microchip that they, you know, is even more fraudulent that they create for you. Right? With their new blockchain system, right? It's all Luciferian. It's all satanic antichrist stuff. And they want you to call, you know, all these other people the Antichrist, not, you know, their son, Sananda. You know, the being of light that comes to deceive you as Jesus Christ, right? Sananda Kumara, right? Son of Sanat Enki, the peacock angel. Satan, the god of this world and the Galactic Federation of Light, right? Pushing all this stuff. You know, this guy right here, you know? And don't be fooled, because he's trying to frame Zeus or Enlil or whatever his name is, Yahweh, for being, you know, Beelzebub, being the one doing all this stuff. That's not him. It's Lucifer Enki. That's him and Brahma. Brahma is not God. The four Kumaras come from Brahma. And Brahma comes from Brahman. So how is Sananda possibly the son of the one true God? There it is, proven, huh? An Alpha Draconian Sanat definitely deceived you all, huh? Yeah, point the fingers at the reptilians underground that you created. And it'll be the problem react solution, right? Just like every other, you know, thing, you know. Look at the Al-Qaeda over there. Look at ISIS we created over there. Look at Saddam over there. You know, look at Osama working for the CIA. You know, look at that. You want to stop using U.S. dollars? How dare you? We're going to kill you then. We're going to just steal all your oil and just take over your country. We're going to go get Gilgamesh. All right? And we're going to, you know, do whatever we want to do. All right, we'll bomb the Twin Towers and kill everybody. And make it a sacrifice for Baal Moloch. Right? No big deal. Pull out the insurance company policy right before. Right? Lie to the people, controlling the news media. Right, controlling the CIA, the FBI, counterintelligence, you know. You're in the counterintelligence program. Anybody that says anything, we'll attack them. We'll slander them. You're a rapist. You're a pedophile. You're a terrorist. You're a serial killer. You're a Satanist. You're an antichrist. You're the antichrist. You false prophet. You're a threat to national security, aren't you, buddy? Listen, bitch, we don't care if you're getting raped. That's what you are now. That's all we're going to see. One way or another, checkerboard. Think about it, okay? Black or white, that's it. You're the black. We're the white. We're the government. We're the gods. Die off slowly. Everybody better help, or you're next. Right? Target individuals, right, government whistleblowers, right, soldiers, right, everybody in the world, right, everywhere. How do you feel about all this? This leaked intelligence, this classified? Should it be? They're killing you off. They want to distract you with fake money. They want to distract you with fake news. Well, they kill you all off and you know, satanize, demonize your children right in front of you. You know, while they control Hollywood, they control the music industry, they control everything going into their eyes and ears. You know, they want to make sure they go to hell, right? They want to make sure that their last years are spent being total slaves, you know, serving the wrong master, because you can only have one master, right? You know, only thinking about their body, you know, having sex with each other, you know, younger and younger ages so they can experience it with these brain technologies from a distance, of course. The top dollar. And also, you know, so they can burn in hell for all their sins. You know, and real God didn't want that. By the way, it was never real God that gave the commandments. That was Enlil, Yahweh, you know, but there's Enki Yahweh too. And they're working together to get you and your souls. You know, be a sheep or a goat. Pick one on their judgment day. You know, by the way, Brahman, the real spirit, that the Native Americans and all the other ancient cultures worship is the one true God. So, you know, there's no way that the Holy Spirit, that being, came from the Father and the Son, right? Because there could be no Father and the Son without the original androgynous spirit that has no gender, correct? How else could there be a God? How else could there be a life? Spirit over mind over matter, right? If everything comes from the Spirit, the source God, then how did they create the source, the Spirit? How did that happen? Wait, so they inverted the pentagram, flipped spirit on the bottom there. They inverted the rainbow and the chakras, put red on the top and, you know, made it the gay pride. You know, Lucifer's gay pride, right? Because he's clearly a homosexual himself. Maybe he was gay for his brother. Maybe he was gay for Enlil or his daddy Anu. Maybe he had some, you know, they wouldn't let him be what he wanted to be. So, you know, he rebelled, you know. But just so you guys know, none of them rebelled against real God, technically, but did the whole time by being evil. You know, none of them even knew, met the real God, the unknowable, ineffable Brahman. I'll show you. Wait, let's go on ChatGPT. It'll show you for itself. Create a text chart comparing Brahma and all the other false gods and Brahman, the real God. And then beneath that, list 10 names for the false gods and then 10 other names for Brahman, the real God. And information about who worshiped them all throughout time. Under each. So here we go, guys. Watch this. This is going to happen right in front of your eyes. Ready? Here it is. You're about to see. There's a lot of differences. You can go more than this. Let's go to the desktop version. And here we have it. So the nature of Brahma is creator God of the universe, but the nature of Brahman, the supreme God, is the ultimate reality, formless and infinite. So it doesn't create this flawed life, right? Because this is not life. The road is narrow. The gate is narrow that leadeth to life, said Christ. And few will find it. Most are led to destruction because people are destroyed by lack of knowledge. And knowledge is what you need. Like this. This is knowledge, right? Or what happens? You get deceived by Mr. Sanat, Satan, Kamara, and you're so stupid that he can use the name Sanat and Santa, and you won't even connect that to Satan, right? No, that's a conspiracy theory. That's crazy. And he can laugh every day at you. Well, he steals you and your children, right? From God? How about that? The red outfit and the materialism and the lying to your kids and the material world, the gifts and, you know, all that, right? That's not a red flag? Role responsible for creation, beyond creation, sustains everything. So God's within us all, within every atom, within every molecule, within every heart, within every mind. There's God. That is God. You are God, but you're not God, because God is you, but you're not God. But you're made of God. Less commonly worshipped, Brahma. Venerated as the ultimate reality, Brahman. Depicted with four faces and arms. So he's not just two-faced, he's four-faced. Non-anthropomorphic, formless. So there's something called formlessness that we're supposed to be, not informed, enslaved, and trapped in matter, and time and space, in a matrix, right? We were told that, right? Didn't Christ tell us that? To become at one, to attain atonement, at one-ment, to merge back with God, to ascend, to transfigure your body to light, merge beyond the light, beyond the darkness, beyond duality, back to the one true formless God, with everyone else up there with him, right? What about mentioning Hindu texts, Brahma, but central concept in Hindu philosophical texts still? So Hindu still, right? So if Brahma, you know, the same religion as Brahman, well, then you see Brahman as the real God. And Brahma essentially is like Satan, right? You know, with the Vishnu, the Shiva, and all these guys coming from him, right? So they're just composites of the one Satan God, Lucifer, right? Satan. So don't be fooled by, you know, Democrat, Republican, and Lil or Enki or Anu or Marduk or Nurgle and all this stuff. Because those are all deceptions and distractions from the real devil, huh? And a real God. So there you go. You can see. Here's some ultimate creator names. Don't be fooled, guys. They're trying to trick us with, oh, here you got the freedom of religion. You got the freedom of politics. Of the state. You know, pick whatever you want about the state and the government. You know, they've been manipulating us like that with church and state since, you know, for thousands of years. And now they got the final checkmate on us. You know, the new world religion and the new world government. And they've been using money to enslave us for all these years. And now they got one more check made for the currency, the QVCC or the QVC and the other one, right? So either way, they're both connected to blockchain, a quantum supercomputer connected to your brain, beyond what you know, turning our thoughts more and more into noise to everyone else, connecting us in a CIA cybernetic hive mind, right? So do you want to experience the thoughts of your family members, of your mother, your father, your sisters and your brothers and your significant others? How about your coworkers? Do you want everyone to have your secrets? Do you want to know when they're having sex? Do you want to hear them having sex in your head, the thoughts that they're having? Is that what you want? You want your children's thoughts connected in your mind? Well, that's what they're trying to slowly do to put you in their hell. So you kill yourselves, to depopulate you, or you kill other people. And then control your thoughts and turn your thoughts into noise, you know, to everyone else. Is that what you want? You want this hell on earth, guys? You want to die off? You want this? You want to burn in hell? Their hell? Or their false heaven as a star? You want to be a star, guys? Oh, yeah, that's what that is. You want to be a fallen angels like them? Be a star? Burn up in the false heaven for them, for Lucifer, for the dragon? Is that what you want, guys? Like all those other stars? Those celebrity stars? Is that what you want? You want to burn in hell or burn in the sky, guys? I don't. I'll tell you that. I'll never join them. Jilluma, not I. Illuni, not I. You know? Don't join them, guys. If you're in them, remember, God owns your soul. You don't. You didn't make a real deal. And the devil wouldn't honor it anyway. He's going to kill you anyway. So you might as well recognize there was never a real deal, guys. And they put the fear in you. Oh, you want to be evil? You love him. You love him. Let me show you what you look like. All you government agents, you Smith agents. You came and smoked some weed. Smoke some weed, guys. Break out of that. Mind control. Yeah, how about you soldiers? Soldiers, huh? Did you sell your soul too? How about all you cops out there that everyone calls pigs? You know, they call you their lap dogs, right? Their pets, their dogs. You're the little dogs to the top dog, Satan. D-O-G, the opposite of G-O-D, right? But still, he's the G in that Freemasonic compass, Masons. Don't you know that? That's who you worship in Lucifer, ask the 33 degree or higher.
Yeah! Holy shit, I didn't expect that! Fuck out of here! Shit, I can't believe these guys are here! That's fucking crazy! And your timing couldn't be more perfect. It's been a long time since any of us have eaten. And you three gentlemen look delicious. What is
that? Now, did your God expect this? Does your government expect this? They all know everything, right? How about, do you know that they call humans human meat? Being, you know, alpha draconians, reptilians, and other races that eat humans. You guys know that? That all you guys look like Channing Tatum right here.
What have to do with
what is he talking about?
I'm a cannibal, hombre. We're gonna fucking eat your ass.
Fuck you, you can't eat us. Fuck that, man.
I do whatever the fuck I want, when I want. I butt fuck this dude. See that? I fucking slide right in that shit. I do whatever I want. This is my gimp.
Now, this is what they're putting in front of your kids. This is what your kids watch. So if you have a problem with it, then have a problem with it, right?
Channing, introduce yourself.
Hey, what's up, man?
Y'all cool?
That's Channing Tatum.
That's Channing Tatum, dude. What the fuck? Channing fucking Tatum. I found him wandering on the freeway. I collected him, made him my bitch. Get off my dick. I call him Channing Tate Yum.
Hardcore, man.
I got him trained good. Watch, he goes strict. Wait, shake hands.
Now keep in mind, guys, in real reality this is happening. So Mr. Channing Tatum is actually Lucifer's bitch, right?
Create a diversion.
Yeah.
You and Jay make a run for it.
What? Danny's gonna eat you.
Listen. Full on sacrifice.
Where would he get the help he
needs? Like the ending
to it. It's Channing fucking Tatum, dog!
I love him.
That's you. You love him. You love Lucifer, right, guys? You're Channing Tatums. We're gonna call you all Channing Tatums from now on. Alright? Karens and Tatums. Karens and Channing Tatums, guys, because you love Lucifer dying off, right? You love to die off for Lucifer and burn in hell, right? You love Sanat Kumara. You love Brahma. You love all his composite beings. You love all his avatars. You love all his lies, all his divisions, how he contradicted himself and deceived all of you in different ways all throughout these years, huh? You love how you're the scum of life to everyone in life, how, you know, you're not going to make it. You got no hope now. You're surrounded by everyone that knows what garbage you are, who knows you're a part of, trying to genocide them off for your cult, your club, your elite, your establishment, your Illuminati. And we know you're in on it too, Trump. Yeah, you joined the Zionist Illuminati, right? You became a Jew. You converted to Judaism, didn't you, Trump? Yes, you did. You converted to Lucifer. And you know what? You were always working for Lucifer because Lucifer is the white hats. Yes, Lucifer's the white hats, the false divine, and the black hats, the synagogue of Satan, right? It's so obvious. We're in the Matrix. He's the black and the white, the checkerboard either way. And you're going to stay in that checkerboard. And that checkerboard means whatever he says. That's your whole existence. That's the yin and the yang, man. That's your whole reality. And he'll tell you what that reality is. A picture's worth 1,000 words. Okay, that's the picture. It's 1,000 words. And he'll tell you what those words are and what they mean, right? And that's it. There's no more other words. There's no more other pictures. Don't think anything else. That's the box you're in. And that's what's on the walls of that box, okay? And you don't want anything else. Why? Why? Because...
You need the pineapple too.
It's Channing fucking Tatum, dog!
I love him.
Because you love him. Right? And we're sick of you guys. We're going to hunt you down now because self-defense, you're engaging in open warfare. Are you trying to murder us, guys, right? You're raping and trafficking people from a distance with brain technologies. You're putting up your 5G towers. You got thousands of FEMA concentration death re-education camps everywhere. So you can brainwash everyone to think that, no, there's no mark of the beast. No, there's no devilry going on. No, it's all religious programming. No, we're going to kill all this religion. They're threats to us. We're going to have a new religion, though. That's not a threat. No, Lucifer's religion is not a threat, right? What about the Luciferin, the Luciferase, and all the other Lucifer stuff that says Luciferin? How about the liquid death that they're putting in the stores, you know, that's everywhere, that they actually, you know, do rituals on, that they, you know, openly say, you know, they do that, and they show you a video of the witch that they hired doing that, and, you know, also, you know, let you sell your soul online on their website. And how about these satanic after-school programs? And how about, think of this, let me end it with this right here. They want to get everyone to hate Christians more and more. You know, after they altered the Bible, they replaced God with Satan. Or they replaced, you know, whatever other fake God there was with Satan. Right? The Anunnaki, either way, right? The primordial beings, they were never God, they're never Brahman. You know, Brahman is not a creator. And they're creator beings that doomed us down here. And we need to get out of here, and that's what Christ told us, right? That's what the being, the Holy Spirit of God working through that man told us. Yeah, he said, the same spirit in me is in you, and the spirit clearly is the God, right? But what did? They created a triangle, pyramid, trinity, and flipped it upside down on you. They flipped the pentagram, they flipped the chakras, they flipped everything, and made you have Lucifer's homosexual pride, huh? And wave that flag around. Well, now that's what this flag stands for, okay? That flag that you're waving around? That's what it stands for, all this. Remember this now. As this goes viral and exposes your devil God, and all your stupidity and naivety, and how you committed treason against us all and the real God, and how you all try to genocide us off with slow kill, psychological operations, gaslighting the victims. Yeah, you want to gaslight. You're the gaslighters. You're the lord of scum, lord of gaslighting, lord of mind control, lord of manipulation of division, deception, right? Restriction, right, Lucifer? You're the lord, all right. You're the lord of doom. You're the lord of overwit. You're the lord of game over for you. You're the lord of your own doom, okay? You're the lord of your own life exposed. Your life of lies, your life of evil, your creation, your matrix, your soul harvesting system has now been exposed. Your universe has been exposed, Marduk and Enki, Anu, all you Anunnaki gods are demonic, disgusting, abominable parasites, and you have been exposed as the greatest enemies against us all, and especially the one true God that you cannot usurp so much anymore so easily, can you? And of course, everything will go on because you control the world. But he who controls the past now controls the future. And who controls the present now controls the past. He who controls the past now controls the future. And who's controlling the present now? Testify. It's right outside your door. Ladies and gentlemen, what they do here is target people worldwide. But they're not just targeting people because they're terrorists, because they're threats to national security. No. They're targeting women and children, mostly, because they're raping and trafficking them. Now, what they do is something called beta sex kitten programming, or just beta programming. I did this to one of my ex-girlfriends, Bianca Pacheco. Now, it's ironic that her initials are BP. We can remember beta programming, how she is a beta sex kitten with the monarch butterfly and the droopy left eye and Luciferian programming within her mind, just like I was when I was a kid before I converted to God. And the truth, and not being a total slave. So, you know, someone like, you know, Beyonce would be a perfect example of a beta sex kitten that has been programmed, but went, you know, evil and dark and decided to be a satanic priestess instead of, you know, being recognized as a victim of human trafficking and mind control. You know, Ashley Tisdale would be someone that, you know, turned to God that, you know, is a beta sex kitten. And talked about it, voices in her heads. You know, this is how they do this. The target individuals are like these celebrities, only they did not sell their souls to become rich and famous. All right, so all of these people, you know, you want to see an investigation go on, if your government doesn't investigate it, they actually help create these beta sex kittens and these alpha program, delta program, super soldiers and special agents and school shooters and, you know, all these different things, these Manchurian candidates and politicians and doctors and lawyers and judges and presidents and popes and kings and queens. That's how they keep them totally handled under their control in a life of lies and evil. Right? That's how you do it. You use neurolinguistic programming, mind control techniques that are verbal, okay, like, you know, weaponized psychology, slate of mouth tactics, conversational hypnosis. That's how they create the undetectable total mind control slaves. And if you want to learn more, look up Fritz Springmeier, Fritz with a Z, Springmeier, How to create an undetectable... Oh, sorry. How the Illuminati create an undetectable total mind control slave. Oh, wait. The Illuminati formula to create an undetectable total mind controlled slave. There you go. That's what it's called. And it's completely free on the internet. And it tells you how the CIA and the FBI and the NSA and Hollywood and the music industry, or just, you know, basically Satanists and Luciferians and Antichrist worshippers, create beta sex kitten programmed mind controlled slaves and then use them against celebrities and politicians and anyone they can to lie about how, you know, they raped them or they molested them or they enslaved them or they programmed them or they did this or they did that. They cheated on them or they did, you know, whatever. And they use them as damsels in distress, pawns, to, you know, ruin other people's lives or get them to join the Illuminati or, you know, get them, you know, to not be listened to by everyone else because they believe the worst of the worst lies about them. And now every single one of these hundreds of millions or more and counting target individuals has experienced this. Every single day, the devil himself, Lucifer and Ki, Sanat Kumara, the god of this world, working in the Galactic Federation, and his son, Sananda, the false Christ, the Antichrist, that has been exposed irrefutably as being Ra, Horus, Tammuz of Nimrod, you know, the fake Christ, has been caught. You know, they're doing this worldwide, and they're acting like holy, loving father and son and all this stuff, and they got their governments. No, they love us. They're non-human, you know. Just keep in mind, though, that, you know, the dragon and Ki, the snake Enki, he's an alpha draconian, or he's the chief, he's the original dragon. You know, he's Satan, Lucifer. So, I mean, if you want to worship him as the good guy, get rid of it. But he's the peacock angel. He's not God. And he's got a father who's apparently Brahma, and Brahma's got a daddy, Brahman, right? The real God. So, you know, they're all caught either way. And all you guys got programmed, you got mind controlled with all these religions and all this stuff from Hollywood. And all these disgusting fuckers have been just raping and trafficking women and children from a distance now instead of doing it in person. I mean, they do it in person, too. But they use beta sex kitten program on your girlfriends, on your husbands, your boyfriends, your wives, your mothers, your fathers, your children. This is how they do it from a distance now with biocommunication technologies, voice of God weapons, synthetic telepathy, bio-API, remote neural monitoring from the NSA. You know, CIA, FBI, NSA are all working together on this literally for Lucifer. They're all Luciferian Satanists, and they're exposed. And how many people have blown the whistle on that? Ted Gunderson, creator of the Amber Alert, you know, creator or the leader of the counterintelligence program they're still doing unlawfully today, that came forward and said he's sorry for attacking Martin Luther King directly and his family back in the day. You know, he said that the once great CIA and FBI and NSA are all satanically controlled, that they traffic your kids, that they rape your kids, that they take your kids, they kidnap your kids for the elite that they work for. You know, that they're sociopathic, that Hollywood, you know, lies and makes you think that there's something good because they control Hollywood. The devil owns Hollywood. The devil owns the whole world because you're on the devil's planet. And guess what? They're set to depopulate everybody by 2030. That means you have under 7 years to die. And then you burn forever in hell because most don't make it to heaven, right? So this whole time, they're making you work for their fake money, jump through hoops, be their little slave bitch, and you're going to die in less than 7 years and burn in hell for eternity, they say. So good luck loving your fake devil gods of the Galactic Federation of False Light, working with your United Nations of Lucifer, and taking your lives with his Antichrist son, pretending to be Jesus, sending him down here to divide and conquer you all, because you'll all be Antichrist really soon, because if you go against him, you're an Antichrist, and if you don't go against him, you're an Antichrist, right? So good luck in complete chaos so that they can pretend they're the order with their new world order and take your souls in the harvest of souls, as they call it, the event that they've been waiting for all these years for everyone to worship Lucifer as God. And if they don't, they'll consume your souls and use it to power their solar system. Yay! You know, hallelujah to the Anunnaki gods, right? Amen. Amon-Ra. Amen. Him, his son, the Antichrist, Amon-Ra, right? Marduk, Mars. The one that killed Tiamat and Apsu and made the planet and helped create humanity, right? And then they pretended like they were the holy gods, huh? Hey, good luck with the Enuma-Elish and the first creation stories and all the other creation stories contradicting themselves and all the religions contradicting themselves, even their own religion, you know, individually contradicting their own selves. And all the people contradicting themselves, being in the dark, while they, you know, distract you, all that. They're trafficking, they're programming, they're mind controlling, they're possessing, you know, men, women, and children worldwide, even government agents that can't save you. You know, and they're also pretending to be gods, so, you know, what's the God going to do to help you? When everybody worships them instead and God's pissed off. But anyways, you know, here's your life. You know, shout out to you, Bianca Pacheco. Thank you for getting raped over and over so many times by these scumbags that you, you know, you got mind control and you talked about it. We appreciate you for, you know, being all messed up in your head and, you know, proving that you're a beta sex kitten. Yeah, we needed that. You know, all you other, you know, raped victims out there, thank you for getting raped every day. That's what God says. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right? Thank you for being raped. Thank you for being trafficked. Thank you for being tortured. Thank you for being mind control program. Thank you for being used and abused as pawns and as patsies and, you know, things to blame they're raping you on. Because you're a terrorist. You're a threat to national security. You're raping their lives. You're stealing. You're thieves stealing their livelihood. Like, they didn't steal your innocence. They didn't steal your souls. No, you stole theirs. You stole their divine image. You stole their ability to be worshipped because, you know, you made everyone think they're what they are. You know, so thank you guys. Thank you for doing that because it's really important, you know, to keep doing that, to keep, you know, letting those gods know that they don't own you, that they can't just have sex with women and children and men and make them gay whenever they want. You know, they can't just jump into our heads and use brain technology with 5G and Neuralink or whatever they've been using to just violate people in their dreams like it's Strange Days. You know, Strange Days we're living in, guys, the movie. You know, here's an inception for you. You know, we in the Matrix, right? All right, well, what do you think they're doing? You're their property. You're their human meat. You know, they consume your energy, your life force, because they're fallen angels. And fallen angels rape human women and make giants, right? Well, now they just do it from a distance with technology because spirits can interact demonically. You know, demons, spirits, all these beings can interact through technology just like we can. What do you think your body is? It's biological technology. What do you think you are? You're a spirit inside that biological technology. Thanks for watching. Good luck to you all. So what do you call a messiah that doesn't save the majority of people of life at the end of a very long life's time? Yet it's not life because the road is narrow, the gate is narrow that leadeth to life. People find it, and with great power comes great responsibility. Knowledge is power, and our people are destroyed by lack of knowledge. And they knew that knowledge the whole time. You're waiting. Are they ready to accept that knowledge? Well, all these years, we were told that the majority of people were not going to make it to heaven. And we're also told there's a depopulation program ongoing to reduce our population down to under a billion or under 800 million by 2030, and then keep it under 500 million or half a billion after that. So what would that mean if the majority of people are not going to make it, and we have less than 7 years before the majority of the people on this planet are wiped out? Well, let's figure it out, shall we? And remember, the gods that you think are gods are Anunnaki. You know Sanat Kumara? You know Sananda Kumara? You know the Ashtar Command and the Galactic Federation of Light? Well, that just happens to be the Peacock Angel, Enki, the rapist. Type in Enki raped in quotes. The usurper, type in Enki usurped in quotes. The murderer, type in Enki murdered in quotes. You know, framing his brother. You know, he's Lucifer. And he framed his brother, Enlil, Zeus. You know, we're talking about Poseidon, that is. You know, Ptah, the god of this earth. You want to blame for it all. The brotherhood of the snake leader, who pretends to be Archangel Michael. And all these different things pretends to be Christ. With his son, the father, number one. You know, Sananda, who pretends to be Jesus. Right? And he's Marduk, Ra, Nimrod, Tammuz, Horus, with Isis, you know, Samiramis, Lilith, whoever. You know, it's even the whole world. It's even the government's usher in the New World Order, right? Divide and conquer, sheep and goat. You know, get up in the lake of fire, huh? They're fire being, aren't they? You know, they want to harvest some souls? Oh, the harvest of souls. Oh, the event, aka Judgment Day, right? What are we going to do about that, guys? What are we going to do if they get us to genocide Christians? Calling the Christian God Satan when they're Satanists, right? You know, come on. We're not going to do that, are we? We can't do that together. We're all in this together, guys. So, what are we going to do? Are we going to allow them to divide and conquer us and let everybody be called the Antichrist when false Christ comes down here? Either way, how do we call it out now in the interest of national, international, galactic, and intergalactic, and universal, and multiversal, and omniversal security? Good luck to you all, mate. Real God be with you.
Listen, if the whole world was listening right now, and we all decided to get on our knees and cry and beg God for forgiveness, right? What would happen then? Because it says in the Bible, no matter what, the majority of people ain't going to make it, they're going to go to hell, right? So, what then? Would it be impossible? Or it's possible, right? But it can't be possible, because, you know, would God be a liar at that point? Would he be wrong? Or would he be a sociopathic, psychopathic murderer? Which one? How? How could we change the prophecies, right? Let's just say hypothetically, everyone heard this message right now. We all decided, no, we love God. We want to be saved. God wants to save us, right? So, would God be wrong then? To save us? Or, just doing us all anyway? Is it real God, or is it Sanat Kumara, Santa Claus, up in the Galactic Federation of Light, and Key, the Peacock Angel, the Fallen Angel, Lucifer, playing God, and his son, Sananda, you know, or is it the real God? It doesn't really make sense, does it? Now, ask yourselves, if it is those Kumaras, the Eternal Lord of Earth, and his son, claiming to be Jesus Christ right now, with the Anunnaki, in a spaceship, Wormwood, Planet X, Nibiru, whatever that is up there, that's working with the government, ushering the New World Order, well then, you know, just know this right here, just in case that happens, right? That Sanat and Sananda are either father and son, or brothers. Sons of Brahma. And Brahma is not God. Brahma is said to be the real original Lucifer, or the Demiurge, or whatever, creator, being. And Brahman is the absolute God, the original source. God. So, think about that. Let's say, hypothetically, Sananda is the son of Sanat. Well, Sanat is not God because he's the son of Brahma. Because there's four Kumaras. Look them up. This is basic Hinduism. But Brahma is not God because Brahman is God. And if you look up, ask ChatGPT, ask any AI, create a text chart comparing Brahman, Brahmin, and you'll see they're completely the opposite, basically. That Brahma is basically Satan. So that's just hypothetically if Sananda is the son of Sanat. Let's say they're brothers. Well, that just contradicts what they said. Then Sananda is not the son of Sanat, and they're deceiving you either way there, too. And still, Brahma is their dad, and Brahma is not Brahman. So that should help save you all either way. So let's say a Messiah is the biggest savior ever. It saves more people than anyone else, right? Not the majority of people don't get saved, right? And what about a father, a mother, a brother, a family member that watches you get tortured in the worst of the ways, you know, raped, violated, enslaved, tyrannically ruled, you know, messed with in the worst of the ways? You know, what would you call them if they watched that? You'd call them a deadbeat, right? You'd call them a criminal. Right? Spit on them, you know, lock them up, kill them, you know? So that's an insult to God, isn't it? To believe that God would be that and divide and conquer you, like all this Democrat, Republican, left and right, red and blue stuff. Sheep and goats says in the Bible, don't be a sheep, right? Don't be a sheep. We know not to be a sheep. But definitely don't be a goat, right? Don't be a scapegoat. So, you know, don't get divided and conquered. Find the middle truth. See the antinomy, multifamily. These creator gods, look it up. Enki of the Anunnaki, Ptah, the peacock angel, Sanat. He was ordered to destroy humanity, but he saved Noah apparently during the flood and kept it ongoing. So it's all illegitimate if it's that. That's true. And the first creation story, the Enuma-Elish, has his son Marduk helping him create the earth and humanity. But guess how? After slicing up their parents, killing their mother and father, and making a planet and humanity with them. So that's a little messed up. You know, that's a little bit different from the Bible, but that definitely predates the Bible, and it's the first creation story in all of history. So, I mean, after that, things were just kind of still continuously dark. People believed that they went straight to the underworld after death, and that they even needed to pay to get there. They needed to ride from the Grim Reaper or something, you know, get on the ferry to get over down across the water to get down to the underworld, because they were so lucky if they could do that. You know, like, think of all, you know, all the different beliefs that people have had, how many thousands of different gods. And look at Moloch, I mean Marduk, I mean Nimrod, and Tammuz, right? Horus, right? Look at them. They're the saviors, too. December 25th, you know, every Christmas we worship them. You know, Jesus was born in September or October or something, you know, not December. So we know that they made these holy days, you know, full of holes in their stories about why they're there, why we repeat these rituals every year. So, I mean, we just got to connect the dots, guys. But this is a message to, you know, just to spark people's curiosity about, you know, imagine, you know, this message got worldwide, you know, this went viral, you know, God helped it to help save us, you know. Well, the prophecy said the majority are just going to be doomed anyways, and, you know, how else are they going to get their solar energy when they're cut off from the real God? Please leave some comments. Thanks. I'm hoping that maybe this could, you know, change the future or something. I don't know. Or would that make God wrong, or a sociopath? We had to die anyways, or maybe that wasn't God. Maybe it was Enlil or Anu or Enki, like we were told, and not the real God. What do you guys think? The Anunnaki? Maybe the ones that are there right now to take over the planet? Possibly. And it just makes sense. But if not, maybe it was Brahman the whole time. The uncreated God that doesn't have a creation. You know, the original God within us all. I don't know. Maybe you know the answer and you can tell us in the comments. Please tell us in the comments, guys. No disrespect. Please let us know. Thanks. Imagine sharing your thoughts with your partner, your family members, your friends, strangers, your teachers, your classmates, your coworkers. Imagine that. Knowing their intimate thoughts all the time, being in a hive mind. That would be doom, right? Be like hell, right? Well, what do you think they're doing with the Neuralink and the 5G? It's got to be stopped, guys. At least the Neuralink, not the 5G. Connecting all things, including our brains. Just had to put that on record. The governments worldwide, the world in general, everyone worldwide. We do not want a hive mind. We do not want that, do we, guys? Because they'll usher us into that slowly but surely over time. We do not stop them now. That is the highest priority. Interest of national and international security. Stop that in the new world order of Satan, Lucifer, Enki, Sananda, Sanat, peacock angel, fallen angel, any jinn or other non-human being, false god. He needs to give up that illusion, trying to take over everyone and everything. Just release that idea, right? All you guys need to give up that delusion of having a hive mind, a cybernetic hive mind with the CIA, the FBI, the DOD, US military. Yeah, you guys using hive minds right now, right? Do not link us in a hive mind. It's suicide, right? It's a message for you all right here, right now. Reminder, you know, all the videos that I've made all these years. You know, that is probably one of the most absolutely vital videos that I've made right here, right now. And I'm hoping that you are doing that as well. Make some videos, guys. We do not want a hive mind. Don't want to share your thoughts, guys. Just remember that, all right? Remember that. Spread it. You guys want to see a magic trick? This is what I learned from doing my own investigations into reality. I'm going to show you how to find the scum of life so quickly. You ready? Watch this.
Watch how we can find the scum of life. Our enemies, our traitors. The enemies of God and the people. Ready? Watch how easy this is. Just look up their usernames, guys. Hail Satan. Let's see who's got Hail Satan. Look at all these retards. Ready? Look at all the Hail Satans. Look at how many retards there are. Take a look. Look at all these idiots. Imagine if the government found them and, you know, saw them as the cancerous viruses to life that they are. Threats to national and international security, right? Trying to undermine and overthrow our government and our people, working for the God of this world, Satan, right? 2 Corinthians 4:4. Take a look at these idiots. Look at how many there are. You think there's no Satanist, huh? There's no Satanism, guys? Look at all the Satanists right here. Look at them all, guys. Look at them all taking over the country. How many are not human, though? Did you ever think of that? How many are not human? How many of these accounts are not human beings? Think about that. Take a look at how many there are. Wow, it just keeps going and going and going and going and going. Look at how idiotic these people are. Look at them all. Look at how many there are. There's no Satanism. There's no Satan. Then why are they saying Hail Satan? Who are they hailing then? Hey, Hail Lucifer. Let's try that one now. Take a look at all the idiots that say that. Oh, Hail Lucifer all over the place. Let's just keep scrolling. Now I'm just making some baked potatoes right now on my break, you know, just taking a break here from cooking. And look, I'm doing more than your fucking government. Look at that. A little video. Look at these assholes everywhere taking over the country, huh? Using the United Nations and their Luciferian operations, their New World Order. Take over the whole freaking government, huh? Oh, hang on. Not all those were Hail Lucifer, right? No. All right, where's it end? Oh, it's not very far up there. Still going with Lucifer. All right, how about Hail Baal? His son, right? Nimrod, Tammuz, Horus, Ra. How about that? Users, look at this. Look at all these users. Users of God. They say there's no God, right? They use God every day. They're delusional, mentally ill morons. You're in God. Everything here is made of God. There is no life without God. And your phony-ass gods are going to be permanently separated from God and everyone in life. Is that what you want to be? Going to be cut off from everybody because you're too stupid to live on? Because your cancerous fucking viruses with your filth, with your garbage, with your mentalities, with your perversions, your corruptions, your compromisations of everyone and everything. You got to invert all of reality around, huh, guys? For your devil dad. Because he can't be God unless he does that. He can't pretend to be what he's not unless he makes everyone think it's opposite day every day. Everything's the fucking opposite. Everything's got to be the opposite. The brain produces consciousness. Fluoride's good for you. Everything's great. That's how you do it. Oh, wait a minute. Ready? You want to see how many people are calling themselves the Antichrist? Take a look at this. How many people call themselves the fucking Antichrist? Look at that. The Antichrist. Here, we'll put the in there for you. Look at these idiots. You guys know the Antichrist is the first one to get tossed in the lake of fire, right? So why would you guys sign up to be called him? You guys are idiots, right? Can we all agree these guys are the biggest idiots on the planet, or some of them, right? Who could be dumber than these people? They're literally volunteering for eternal damnation. And openly, publicly saying it. You know, it says in the Bible to shame these people, right? To trample on the serpents. And let's go beyond Bible. Let's go beyond Christianity. Let's go beyond any individual religion. Let's add them all up. What do they all say? There's a transcendental God and there's a fake God, right? There's some demons, there's some devils, there's some force of evil, and you need to be saved. Well, that's what it basically amounts to, huh? Well, here they are. Here's a lot of them. Here are your enemies. Here are the retards. They work for them. Here. Hang on. Hail Ra. Hail Ra. Ready? Oh, hang on. Hail Nimrod. We'll put that in there. Hail Nimrod. Son of Satan. False Christ. Hail Nimrod. Look at them all. Hail Nimrod. Right? We got Haley Nimrod. That's not the same. All right, hang on. We'll keep going. Hail Osiris. There's another name for you. There you go. Take a look. Hail Osiris. Hello. Oh, hang on. Not too much hails in there, I guess. Usually they just say Hail Satan and all that other stuff. You know, there's people that believe that are Osiris, right? They're Osiris. Or they worship Osiris, right? All these people are saying Osiris. They like Osiris, right? They love Osiris, huh? You know who Osiris is? You should find out. How about Apollo? Same being. Here, take a look. Apollo, Apollo, Apollo. Everybody worships Apollo, huh? Lucifer? You guys worship Lucifer in the form of Apollo, right? You guys worship Lucifer in the form of Enki? Of the Anunnaki? Check out these guys. They're all Enkiists. And kiss my ass. Enki is a rapist, guys. And a rebel. And a fallen being. The goat. The goat. Everybody's saying the goat now, right? Because that's programmed. They want you to call each other the goat. The beast, huh? You're a beast? That's programmed. They want you to call each other beasts. All this stuff is not coincidence. They make it happen. That's why people call you conspiracy theorists. Because they made them do that. They put it out there. They created the term so people would use it, right? It just doesn't happen all on its own. What about COVID-19? Everybody just all of a sudden learned about COVID overnight, huh? Because they made sure you did. Because they control everything. Well, hang on. Let's keep going. Sanat Kamara. Satan. Lucifer. The Galactic Federation. Check them out. Everybody's Sanat Kamara. Everybody's God, right? God of Earth, not God of Life. Right? How about Sananda Kamara? How about Sananda, the false Christ? The one we were just talking about, the other names. Sananda Kamara, Sananda Kamara, Sananda Kamara, Sananda Kamara, Sananda Kamara. How many channel his messages all day long? Yeah, Jesus is talking to me, man. He's an extraterrestrial. Did you know? That's what they believe. Jesus up there in his spaceship at the Galactic Federation of Light lurking with the United Nations to bring in peace and harmony. To get rid of that no good government they compromised and corrupted all these years. Just so they could do it, right? Problem, react, solution, divide and conquer. And who doesn't care? Who thinks it's annoying? Well, you're not going to make it, probably. You see that? Who doesn't think enough into details and wants to ride on the surface of everything and not get into it because it bothers them? You're probably not going to make it. Let me tell you that. I'll be real honest with you. It's tough love. You better care. Or, you know, who's going to care about your loss? When you get what you got coming to you, not because we want it to happen to you, but because, look what we're doing to try to help you so that doesn't happen. All of us, worldwide. How many millions of us are doing this daily? Trying to wake up, have no fellowship with the forces of evil, but rather reprove them, right? That's what we do every day. It's our job. It's our job. You know why? Because if we don't do this job, you guys kill us off. You Holocaust us off. If we don't wake you up, they turn you against us. You think we're the problem. We get killed. And then guess what happens next? You get doomed. You get doomed. And guess what's going to happen when false Christ comes down here? This year, probably. He's not already here. Guess what's going to happen? Every single person on this planet is going to be called an antichrist. Here's why. Because they're going to force you to talk about it. It's in every news station. It's going to be everywhere. It's the rapture. It's Jesus. Watch. If you don't worship him, you're an antichrist. If you do, you're an antichrist. Good luck.
We're about to see footage from 12 years ago that aired on national television to record ratings for the channel that was then taken offline and completely censored. The network even went into people's DVRs and had it erased off of their own personal servers. Congress talked about holding hearings concerning the very episode you're about to see. Ladies and gentlemen, the reason the establishment got so scared was that Dr. Rima Labo is a top medical doctor, and she was also the wife of General Stubblebine, the former head of the U.S. Special Forces in the Army, who treated heads of states of major governments and royalty in Europe. And they told her, as their medical doctor, the plan to depopulate in the Great Colony, with the WTO, the UN, doing it through the vaccines, how they would claim there wasn't enough vaccines, so they would then add dangerous chemicals to them to make them more powerful, which is what they've all done now. So here is the censored report. We're going to post the full show at band.video, but here is 4 minutes and 15 seconds of myself and Dr. Labo laying it all out 12 years ago. How could we do that? We didn't just make this up and it magically all happened the way we said it. No, she had the sources. And I had also done major research on government documents like State Department Memorandum 200 from Henry Kissinger that also laid out plans for depopulation. So here is the video that has the globalists so scared because it exposed the Great Reset 11 plus years before they launched it.
There's an entire agenda afoot to force the population to undergo different type of medical treatments, namely vaccines. We're seeing a medical tyranny being set up, not just in the United States, but worldwide under the UN and the World Health Organization.
Who's behind all this?
The Bilderberg Group. They want a planetary dictatorship so they can carry out their forced depopulation agenda, and they want to do it through the medical system. And that's why vaccines are so important. We know that many of these vaccines turn out to have serious adverse reactions. This is being done by design. They kill you slowly over time. That's why they're called soft kill. And I've got an insider I think you should really talk to, Dr. Rima Labo. But she doesn't live inside the United States because she's so concerned about all the police state developments that are taking place.
As soon as you and I finish,
you're out.
I'm leaving the country.
Enemy. One that is antagonistic to another, something harmful or deadly. For those with eyes to see, humanity is currently under attack by an antagonistic and deadly foe, an enemy that must hide in the shadows to survive. But there is always a money trail, and money is their only real power. So to find the real enemy, we must follow the money. In the documentary Monopoly, Who Owns the World, Tim Gielen does an excellent job of doing this. While there appears to be hundreds of independent companies producing food, they are practically all owned by the same small group of companies. These companies are controlled by their top shareholders, financial institutions such as Berkshire Hathaway, Vanguard, BlackRock, and State Street. This is also who owns Silicon Valley, big tech, the airline industry, the steel industry, agriculture, the textile and clothing industry, both the oil and solar panel industry, tobacco, alcohol, pharmaceutical, electronics, and banking. Just about everything in today's modern world is owned and controlled by these same financial institutions, who are also invested in each other, forming a pyramid of financial power, topped by BlackRock and Vanguard. BlackRock loans money to the Federal Reserve Bank, advises them, and developed their software system. BlackRock itself is owned by Vanguard, and Vanguard, sitting on top of the world pyramid, keeps its shareholders private. But we know that the majority of wealth has been accumulated by inheritance and monopoly, and the same few families have owned most of the world for generations. Families such as Rothschild, Rockefeller, DuPont, Morgan, and Bush. Operating through non-profit foundations, these unelected families are able to rule over the world like kings. This is the way it has always been, whether it be via pharaoh, royalty, papal supremacy, dictator, or investment banker. Mankind has always been managed by the rich and powerful. Freedom is a dream yet to be fully realized in this world. After the American Revolution, our forefathers gave us the tools to realize this dream of self-governance in the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. Tools that will be stripped away unless mankind decides to stand and face their enemy.
Here we need a vast military-style campaign to marshal the strength of the global private sector. With trillions at its disposal, far beyond global GDP, and with the greatest respect, beyond even the governments of the world's leaders, it offers the only real prospect of achieving fundamental economic transition.
For Infowars.com, this is Greg Reese.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
Do you see what I see?
See what I see?
It's a big takeover. It's Agenda 21. United Nations Agenda 21.
We know this will take trillions, not billions of dollars. Here we need a vast military-style campaign to marshal the strength of the global private sector.
We need a vast military-style campaign to do what?
To marshal the strength of the global private sector, with trillions at his disposal.
Who's his? Look what he goes on to say.
Beyond even the governments of the world's leaders, it offers the only real...
Beyond the governments of the world's leaders.
Yeah, so his
disposal
He said this on purpose. He's reading his notes. Who do you think told him to say this?
This was not a fluke. And by the way, there's only a few guys that have been yelling about this. And you know what they've been doing? They've been erasing this off the internet.
We talk about from Daniel, from Book of Revelation, from various passages, there's going to be a global system. It will rise out of Europe. And they will crown their leader, and it will be a he. He's going to be the most powerful leader the world has ever known. The book of Revelation tells us, Revelation chapter 13, that nobody can make war with him. Who can stop him? Absolutely nobody. He obviously is talking about someone. He's talking about someone that's a man. He's talking about someone that nobody knows who he is yet. He's the most powerful man in the world. More powerful is he than all of the global leaders combined. Revelation 17, the 10 kings give their power and authority to the beast. If people can't see it now, James, you have to be in denial.
So let's have a digital health certificate by WHO. If you have been vaccinated or tested properly, then you can move around. So for the next pandemic, instead of stopping the movement of the people 100%, which clogged the economy globally, you know, G20 country has agreed to have this digital certificate using WHO standard, and we will submit into the next World Health Assembly in Geneva as the revision to international health regulation.
I hear the train coming. It's rolling around the bend. And I ain't seen the first time. I don't know when.
It begins. The mark of the beast is now going mainstream. The globalists are taking tyranny digital by microchipping humans to see the proof that the fulfillment of Bible prophecy is well underway. Now, it's written in the book of Revelation, he causes all, both small and great, both rich and poor, both free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hand or on their foreheads, so that no man may buy or sell unless he has the mark, that is the name of the beast or the number of his name. Microchips, wallet mark, will be implanted in the hand and work with digital wallets for contactless payments. Microchips will work with the PureWrist app, and the implant procedure will only take about 4 to 5 minutes, according to the company.
A mediaopoly. The whole media is controlled by a few corporations, thanks to deregulation by the FCC.
You mean Disney, Fox, Westinghouse, and good old GE?
They own networks from CBS to CNBC.
They can use them to say whatever they please and put down the opinions of anyone who disagrees. A footnote protects you from folks who doubt what you say. Now maybe the voices in my head will go away.
But the big shots don't care. They're all sitting pretty thanks to corporate welfare.
What's that now?
They get billions in subsidies from the government. It's supposed to create jobs, but that's not how it's spent. They use tax and soft money to support congressmen who will over weapons programs. Toxic waste where the young ones play.
ING made the bullets that shot JFK.
Hey, I don't mean to scare nobody, but watch this. If you follow me, then you know we only go over real documented facts over here. This right here is a map of the 800 death. concentration. Excuse me, FEMA camps in the United States. And by the way, I'm talking about the Federal Emergency Management Agency. But check this out. There are a list of executive orders that protect and justify the actions of FEMA. And I'm talking about actions that will suspend your constitutional rights that you think you have. Let's get the proof. For the first example, you have Executive Order 11051, which basically allow all executive orders to go into effect in times of international tension, economic crisis, and financial crisis,
We're down here in Galveston, Texas, and we're tearing down this apartment complex. I'm tearing it all down. And we're going to build FEMA concentration camps. They've got us building these concentration camps all over the country to, I guess, the project manager said that they're gonna be rounding up people that refuse to be vaccinated. So I just wanted to let y'all know, as soon as I get it all tore down, we're going to be able to put up tents and stuff. So there you have it, America.
We will not comply with the institution's sick illusion. No, it won't be televised.
I don't care if you think I'm Satan reincarnated.
I really believe this is why God gave us two arms, one for the flu shot and the other one for the COVID shot.
The act of getting vaccinated is the very essence of what the Bible tells us when it says, love thy neighbor.
Nobody's gonna know. Nobody's gonna know.
They're gonna know.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am about to expose all of reality for you real quick, okay? You got United Nations, controlled by Lucifer. You got the Draconians. You got Draconian law, right? They're the fallen angelic races. You got the Nephilim. They wiped them out. They lose, right? Noah got saved by Enki, right? Enki of the Bible, son of Anu, Anunnaki. What happened to Anu, though? What happened to Uranus? What happened? Oh, no. Brother Enlil, right? Playing Yahweh, that was the father, but he usurped the father with the son, the other son, right? And who's the son of Enki? That's Ra, right? But wasn't that Horus or Ra Horthy, right? Became Ra. And what wasn't that Marduk became Ra? Is that the Antichrist? Isn't that the King of Babylon? Isn't that connected with Nimrod and Tammuz? And we got Lilith, aka Isis, right? Aka Semiramis, right? Aka who? You know, we got all these fake gods, the Anunnaki, all right? So connecting that with the United Nations, trying to take us over right now, the Luciferian United Nations, the Galactic Federation with Sanat, Kamara, aka apparently Satan, Kamara, Enki, Kamara, his son, you know, who admitted to being Horus or, you know, another being incarnated, right? So wouldn't that make him the Antichrist? Wouldn't that make him the son of Nimrod or Nimrod incarnated? Wouldn't that make that be the unholy trinity, right? And Ashtaroth, you know, demon of hell. Wouldn't that be Ashtar? Wouldn't that be him? Or, how about Matria, the false prophet? How about the son of Enlil, a.k.a. Zeus, a.k.a. Jehovah, a.k.a. Yahweh, a.k.a. Beelzebub, a.k.a. Baal, being Apollyon, Abaddon, underneath the planet locked up or in the ocean right now. And I heard that Lucifer and Michael worked together to orchestrate this whole thing, and he knows about it, and that's why he's down there going to scapegoat him, and he's one of the scapegoats, but I don't know about that. But I heard that none of them are God, none of them are Christ, and they're all fighting for our souls because they're cut off. Spirit over mind over matter, right? So they want to force us to accept these vaccines, these certificate of vaccinations, these digital ones, which are basically microchips, the mark of the beast, right? So we choose Luciferian, United Nations, or International Courts, the World Health Organization, who? I think the devil, that's who. We have to, you know, expose it all. We're going to stop the New World Order. We're going to stop them, disband the United Nations, the Trojan Horse, and get them out of our countries and stop this evil once and for all. All right, see facebook.com/realityrevealed and tinyurl.com/realityexposed.
Since the beginning of time, all of us have fought against each other for our enemy, against the truth for their lies, against the real God for their fake gods, against the real saviors for their fake saviors, against the real heroes for their fake heroes. We have fought against our people. We have been deceived. We have been mind controlled. We have been going backwards. And it's time to now turn it all around. We have a new operation exposing all of reality and all the deceptions. Go to facebook.com/operationguaranteed or tinyurl.com/OGDoc to move forward with us now. Thank you.
Wow, things are moving so quickly. For a little while there, it was so quiet. It was too quiet. It was the calm before the storm, and now everything's going crazy. If you kept up with my last few videos, I told you a few days ago the government was about to admit that aliens are real. They are talking with them, they are working with them, and they did that yesterday. But there's so much more going on. It's insane. Information is literally making it down the pipeline right now. That infrastructure is said to be going down sometime soon. Waterways and water systems, electrical, hospitals, everything. Like, there's literally something really, really, really big coming. This coincides with every vision I've had, every vision everyone else has had. We've all had the same exact visions, and they all lead to the same place, and that's destruction of certain parts of America. After this destruction, or this partial destruction, what happens? These aliens, these grays, come in, and they turn the entire world into one system. Everyone was talking about what's going to happen the 26th to 26th. Well, the 26th was the end of the quiet before the storm. This whole thing, it all is part of itself. The gray aliens, the invasion, blue beam, every conspiracy theory, it all ties into the same exact thing. Even if you want to say the 3 days of darkness, which is a Catholicism prophecy, you know, it's never spoken in the Bible. I've never received the word myself, but they say, you know, close the doors, close the windows, don't go outside. Could it be because these grays are going to be walking around? I told y'all it's going to be like the movie Signs. These aliens are going to be outside. They're going to be everywhere. No, they're not demons. No, they're not fallen angels. They are flesh and robotic, filled up with demons. That is what they are. You know, the fallen angels are said to be tied up underground, right? Tied up underground for the most part, which is why the military is working underground. And they've been with them making these things. Can't be a demon because a demon is a spirit. Watch my last video. You'll get caught up on all of this stuff. Now it looks like things are about to start getting shut down. Shut down at this disclosure of these aliens, of these grays. Remember, we have three entities. Demons, fallen angels, grays. All separate. Demons are inside the graves because men are putting them in the graves to fulfill Satan's agenda. All this is going on, I see this video last night, where they are literally using facial recognition to go into stores in the United States, other countries as well, but facial recognition, not just facial recognition that goes off your social media. If you post things they do not like, they will not allow you to go into the store.
Big things are happening right now, and we need to be getting prepared for it. Right now, people are being banned from their grocery stores, from their department stores. Major stores are now, and chains are now banning people. These are articles coming out of the New York Times. They are banning people, and they are promoting this as well. They're saying this is a good thing, okay? So we are entering this dystopian future, and people are being locked out of stores. They have to stand up. This is happening in the USA right now, multiple states, where people have to stand outside of a store and have their face scanned before they can enter the store, right? This is happening with multiple chains. It is spreading, and they can deny you service, okay? And they use your social media. Admittedly, I was reading about some of these companies. They admittedly use your social media data to make a profile of you, okay? So that's how they get your facial recognition to begin with. So I'm screwed because I have over 500 videos over with me talking here, so I'm kind of screwed on that. But
things are getting freaking crazy. All eyes have been on the East, right? But yet here in the U.S., we have all this alien activity. We have all this infrastructure breaking. We have certain information coming down the pipeline. We have whistleblowers talking about what's inside of these graves and how they're being created, what the autopsies show. And also, we have cameras going up, making you use your face to enter the store based off your social media presence. We are living in very, very dangerous times. The Bible says men's hearts will fail them for what comes on the earth. Dangerous times. The food, the water. We have CERN, literally summoning Nibiru. We have CERN lifting the veil so demons can easily fly through. We have them controlling emotions from afar. Strong delusions sent forth by God for people that love unrighteousness. The hardening of hearts. The days of Noah, the mixing of iron and clay. Things are going down. Literally had the restrict bill, which is a different name in every country, which is the bill for the mark of the beast, talking about synthetic biology and computing and nanotechnology and all these things wrapped up in one bill having nothing to do with TikTok. The patent 2020-6066, body data on the blockchain. Then you have CBDC on the blockchain. You're going to need a mark in your right hand or your forehead to use your CBDC because both things are on the blockchain. Then we have artificial intelligence controlling almost every aspect of life, and artificial intelligence is just a medium for demons. It's literally ran by demon. That's the processor for AI. It's demon. The deception the world is under is insane. And if you hear and understand what I'm saying, you have got to warn people. You have got to warn people because most will not understand. Most are asleep. Most heads are in the sand and most hearts are already hardened. It's too late for so many people already. All we can do is warn, but we have got to keep warning. And if we don't warn our friends and warn our families, they will follow the grays, the fallen angels, the false prophet to their new God. And they will worship that God thinking that God is Jehovah, Jesus Christ, when in fact it is not. I will continue to put myself at risk and shout this from the rooftop, but we have got to warn everyone that has a slight possibility of waking up because we are there. It could be 1 month from now. It could be 6 months from now. It could be next week. Please share this video and warn people.
If you can't kill the devil and the demons, you know, the evil spirits, what you can do is kill their worship. You know, how do you do that? Well, you need just enough amount of truth. Yeah, that'd be truth, right? I mean, you could lie, but it's better off speaking the truth. You know, for all their worshipers, for all their followers, to not worship and follow them anymore. That's round one, right? That's round one. Round two, if you need a round two, you let them know what they are if they don't accept that truth. You know, what else is true? Like, they're deluded, delusional losers, jokes, sellouts, traitors. You know, basically, deceived, dumbed down, enslaved, possessed, and doomed, huh? And if you need another round, round three is you let everyone else know what they are. Right? You have a big session of laughing at them. Be it not just all that, but, you know, things that are no laughing matter, not just laughing. You know, it's real serious what they are, huh? The most offensive, egregious, heinous things. That's what they work for, right? That's round three. Everyone finds out about that and they sees beyond the smoke and mirrors. You know, beyond the fronts, the covers, you know, like Freemasons up front for Illuminati and Lucifer. You know, they pretend it's not. What's the G stand for? Come on, it's G-A-U-D. Let's go. Right? So, there's the three-step process to handle beings that you can't touch, that you can't kill. By removing all their power that they get from other people. You know, exposing their lies. Exposing how they set them up. You know, like if Lucifer's working for that God the whole time, pretending he was going to win a war, leading people astray, you know, he's caught for that, huh? You know, and, you know, you can type in N key blank, you know, whatever crime, you know, look raped up. There you go, put that in quotes. On Google, Enki rebelled, Enki usurped, right? Look that up. The Peacock Angel Sanat Kumar of the Galactic Federation, you know, ushering in the New World Order with the United Nations, right? With his son, false Jesus, Sananda, right? Look it up. So, how do you handle these beings that you can't touch? Well, you deal with them. Don't worship the Galactic Federation, Sanat Satan Kumar, and his son, the false Christ, the Antichrist, a.k.a. Horus, Ra, Tammuz, or Nimrod, right? Don't worship their mom wife, his mom wife, Samira Miss Isis, right? Don't fall for the unholy trinity. And remember, these are the three steps to handle them. But don't worry, I've been doing this for years. Ah, gotcha! Internationally, baby. Intergalactically, baby. Add it up. Go ahead and look around. International man of mystery, secret agent hand. Right here, man. Listen, if you guys don't have the balls in our government, if you don't have the integrity, if you don't have the honor to call out these United Nations people, these globalists and elitists, these Satanists, these Luciferians, and these Antichrist worshippers for what they actually are, that committing genocide and all this stuff, then let someone like me do it, or any of the other uncountable amount of, you know, increasing numbers of persecution victims worldwide, the so-called targeted individuals, you know, the government agents called Havana syndromes, what they're experiencing, Havana, yeah, voices in their head, voice of God weapons, satellite, you know, biocommunication technologies, remote neural monitoring, all right? No, the voices ain't voices, guys. It's neuro-linguistic programming, conversational hypnosis, sleight of mouth tactics, weaponized psychology, and psychic driving to perform menticide to systematically depattern, repattern your mind, or create dissociative fragmented identities in your mind, like sleeper agents, you know, dissociative parts of yourself that are Satanists, or, you know, sleeper agents, or, you know, school shooters, or celebrities, or politicians, or, you know, whatever they can make you. So that's what it's all about. It's about programming you to either kill yourself, or, you know, join the club, or, you know, be something useful to them. So if you guys don't have what it takes to prove irrefutably, not without, you know, not with guns, you know, we don't need guns and paperwork and council meetings controlled by our enemies and votes, you know, that go to our enemies. We don't need that, guys. You know what we need? We need to use the same thing they've been using to take us over and violate us and deceive us and divide us and conquer us and possess us and doom us all these years. And that's words. Words. Words are so powerful. Look, here's an example. Terrorism, using fear, threats, and intimidation in pursuit of political aims. Giving aid and comfort to our enemies, that's treason. How about genocide? That's depopulation, right? Oh, well, they made it sound good. They also program you to one way or another mentality so they can say everything's great that's evil, and everything that's evil that's great. Right? So that you see it, if too many people are saying it's one way, well, how dare you go against them? You know, then you're on the black side because they're the white, okay? And it's all a game they play. But you don't have to play anymore. So let me say it again. If you guys in our governments don't have that level of intelligence, enough intelligence, and enough awareness, even if you're intelligence agents, you should have this intelligence and awareness, to call out the once called League of Nations, the Trojan horse to America and the whole world, sitting in our, you know, New York right now, been there for all these years. If you're so unintelligent that they've been able to sit there every single day more and more all these years, then you're incompetent and incapable of serving and protecting your people. So bring us in. See targetingexposed.com. See facebook.com/realityreveal. Check out these other channels. Thanks. Maybe that'll help.
This is one of the most shocking videos you're going to see here on the World Wide Web. This is a dollar bill. You get a dollar bill. You fold it in half from top to bottom. Then you fold it one more time. Then you fold it to the corners just like you see right here. You can do this. And then you'll see an evil face there, an evil demonic grimace. The person then put a mirror image side to side, and we can clearly see a demonic face there, folks. There's the eyes. Here's the nose, right? You can clearly see it. The teeth like a skull right there. But it even gets worse and more evil right here in the bottom of the jaw. You see like what looks like to be a Baphomet, a demonic devil right there, folks. If you don't know who the Baphomet is, this is what the Church of Satan worships. This is what the Freemasons have as well, folks. This is a reality. They are coming after our children.
After school Satan clubs are now gaining popularity all over the United States. Ohio, North Carolina, and now Pennsylvania. Temple of Satan is sponsoring all of this, and you can go on their website and check out their handbook that they're teaching little kids.
This is a war on children, they give the cure with the sickness. This is a war on tradition. This is a war on religion. This is a war on the children, they give the cure with the sickness. This is a war. This is a war. This is a war.
Stop!
every single day, myself and an uncountable amount of other people, say enough and do enough to help the entire world to potentially be freed and saved. And every single day, we are disregarded and nothing happens. Today, before even noon, I did that. You can see my previous videos. You can see it all right there, everything that's been said and proven. Today is the day, ladies and gentlemen. Or it will be tomorrow, or the next day, or the next day. We're going to keep repeating ourselves until this world changes. We're going to be the change we wish to see. We're going to be the heroes we've been waiting for. And we're going to fight with the truth and God. So please see this channel and know it's real. Thank you.